Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and welcome to station number 11, where we are going to talk about the anterior compartment of the forearm, sometimes referred to as the flexor compartment of the forearm, because many of these muscles, when they contract, will either flex the wrist or some of the digits of the hand. So let's start with this anterior view. We know we're anterior. We can see the palmar aponeurosis right here. This is the palmar surface of the hand. And we are looking at a superficial dissection first. And the first muscle I want to identify is going to be the brachioradialis. And you can see here that I have an asterisk right next to it. And why do you think that is? Why do I have this as something we need to talk about a little bit more? Well, because conceptually, when we discuss brachioradialis, we typically talk about it as being part of the posterior compartment or extensor compartment. And that is mainly because it is innervated by the radial nerve, whereas most of the nerves or most of the muscles in this region, in the anterior region, are going to be innervated by the median, some by the ulnar, but mostly by the median. So usually this is discussed with the posterior compartment because of its innervation, but as you can see, you can very clearly see the brachioradialis from an anterior view. It's taking up this whole lateral portion of the anterior part of the forearm. It's really not till you get into kind of this area on from here that you are talking about the anterior compartment or flexor compartment of the forearm. Recall though, even though it is often discussed with the posterior compartment, it does play a role in terms of flexion, weak flexion, but flexion of the elbow joint. So this is kind of that oddball, but you can see it really well on this superficial dissection of the anterior forearm. Okay. Next, you can see right here that I'm outlining the pronator teres. So right here is the pronator teres muscle. This is going to be the most lateral of the superficial flexor compartment. It is also going to not extend as distally as the rest of these tendons because it is going to insert on the radius. And as its name would suggest, it will play a role in terms of pronation of the forearm. Next, you have the flexor carpi radialis. So I'm going to put an R right here for that one. You can see the muscle belly right here. And then about in the middle of the forearm, its muscle belly is completely replaced by this long flattened tendon, which is quite dominant in this superficial view. This next muscle right here, we're not having you identify. It has almost the same length of a tendon. This is the palmaris longus. It's not a very functionally important muscle, so you don't have to identify this one, but I did want you to be aware of what that was. And then the flexor carpi ulnaris is going to be the most medial of these muscles. It's so medial, in fact, we can't see the muscle belly very well, but you can see the tendon right there of the flexor carpi ulnaris. One muscle that you can see kind of peeking through here, just deep to the palmaris longus and at the flexor carpi radialis, is the flexor digitorum superficialis, which you can see a little bit better right here where the palmaris longus has been cut. So this is the flexor digitorum superficialis. Oftentimes this is called a part of the intermediate layer. It's the only muscle in the intermediate layer. But sometimes you hear it referred or lumped in with the superficial layer because it does also have an attachment up here in terms of the medial epicondyle. So the flexor digitorum superficialis is just deep to the superficial layer. In fact, you can see it from that superficial layer. And it will have its tendons traveling through the carpal tunnel. The carpal tunnel is in this general region right here. So the tendons are diving deep to this region, and then you can see them kind of popping out in this region, heading towards the digits. Deep to the flexor digitorum superficialis will be the flexor digitorum profundus, which is this whole muscle right here. So you can see most of those superficial and intermediate muscles have been removed in this particular dissection, and you only see the one muscle here, which is flexor digitorum profundus. And again, you will have these tendons that are traversing the carpal tunnel in this region to head to the digits. So you can see this is a really long or a really long muscle, a very flat muscle. It will take up the whole space. If you don't see any other muscles in the region, you know you're likely deep enough to, in terms of the dissection, to see the flexor digitorum profundus. And lastly, the deepest muscle of the anterior part of the forearm, and we know we're still anterior because here's the interosseous membrane here, and this muscle is anterior to that. This is the pronator quadratus, but almost everything has to be removed in the anterior compartment in order to get to the depth that you would need to get to find the pronator quadratus. As its name would suggest, the muscle is going to be quadrangular. I almost think of it as like a little band-aid just above the wrist region. And again, as its name would suggest, it is going to be a powerful pronator of the forearm. All right, excellent. Forearm muscles, I think, are some of the more difficult ones to identify. So take your time here. Find those ones that you still have some questions about, and please reach out with any specific questions, and we'll work through it together. Thanks for your time and attention here, and we will talk the extensor compartment in the next station.